All right, replacing Kirk Cousins, Superflex leagues. This is the big question now. We've got competing teams. You've got Kirk Cousins as your QB2, and boom, Kirk Cousins goes down. So what do we do? I mean, we're looking at some guys out there like Russ, Baker, Geno, Dobbs, Howell, Minshew, Zach Wilson, Danny Dimes. I mean, Heinicke / Ritter. So, Hammer, I'll ask you first. I mean, who are you trying to target? We need to get a QB in here. You are contending, so we need to somehow replace. Who are you willing to spend on? Who do you think is kind of the best bet? Like, who would you be trying to go after?
For me, the best value, and this might surprise you, is Gardner Minshew. Like, the best value here is Gardner Minshew, because I think people still sleep on him from a fantasy perspective, because obviously he is a backup quarterback. But if you remember last year when he took over for Jalen Hurts, I believe that was around Thanksgiving, somewhere near the fantasy playoffs, Gardner Minshew was really good. Obviously, that was a fantastic Eagles team, but this Indianapolis Colts offense has proven to have some really good weapons when you're talking about Michael Pitts, Josh Downs, Alec Pierce to a lesser degree, Jonathan Taylor and Zach Moss are probably as good of a 1-2 combo in the backfield as you're going to get around the NFL at this point. So for my best bang for my buck, I would try and go and get a Gardner Minshew. Now, I know he's played pretty well, so that might kind of cost you maybe a little more than you're willing to spend. But I think the value is still pretty good on a guy like Gardner Minshew, especially because most people probably picked him up off the waiver wire at some point. And right now, Gardner Minshew, the last 3 weeks, he is quarterback 18, quarterback 3, and quarterback 16. So he's giving you some really good value, and the volume is there, right? He's thrown it 55 times, 23 times, 41 times, and 44 times. So the volume is going to be there to give you a safe floor at that super flex position. Now, he's not going to replace Kirk Cousins on a per game basis, but you can rely on Gardner Minshew to go out there and sling it around and get it to Downs and Michael Pittman and the rest of his playmakers. So I'm looking at Gardner Minshew here.
Yeah, I like Minshew. Gardner Minshew's a bowler. He's a bowler. Every way he's been, he's a bowler. He played good when he was in Jacksonville. He played good, for Philly last year, and he's playing good this year. And I think replacing Kirk, and if you're just looking, I know it's dynasty, but if you're just looking for this year to replace him and you're in contention, you got to look for somebody with job security, right? You don't want to go for a Heinicke or a Ritter because you don't know who's going to play on a week-to-week basis. They may flip-flop the rest of the year. You know what I'm saying? This one's hot. He's going to get the start. Ritter's going to get – you just don't know. You know what I'm saying? And I like Gardner. I like Sam Howell, too, to an extent. He can put up some big numbers. He's also young. What is it going to cost you to get him? But with him and the things that are going on in Washington, I don't – how long does he have the job? You know what I'm saying? I mean, he's been playing good, but they're starting to sell shit. You know what I'm saying? They sold off Chase Young. They sold off Montez Sweat. Weird things are going on in Washington, and it wouldn't surprise me if, Howell has a bad game or two and they sit him down for Jacoby Brissett to try and get a better pick or something. You know what I'm saying? So I like Gardner Minshew, and surprisingly, I like Baker Mayfield, too. You know, he's gonna be there and he's gonna start. He's the quarterback in Tampa Bay. He has good weapons. He's put up good numbers this year. He's getting a ball of Mike Evans. He's getting a ball of Chris Godwin. You know what I'm saying? And, it looks like he's cured those turnover problems that he's had. So for me, the two, like I'm with Polish Minshew, and another one that I would look to go get on a cheaper side is Baker Mayfield. If you're
so really quick, really, really quick to that Sam Howell point, I was just looking at Sam Howell, and after that massive game last week, and he's had some really big games. I think he's sitting at QB8 right now, which is very surprising.
Sam Howell, I've been all over Sam Howell. I love Sam Howell, and he may be, since he's young and things like that, he may be a little bit more expensive to go get, but he does have, you know, the ability to throw in some of those big games. But like I said, it just Washington is in a weird state right now. You know what I'm saying? And if you're in contention and you're trying to make a run, you can't lose your quarterback for a game or two. You understand? Just because they want to sit him down because he had two bad games, or they're not winning, so they're going to start Jacoby Brissett. So I think Minshew, he's the guy, right? For the rest of the year, it's going to be Gardner Minshew. And I don't see Tampa Bay sitting down Baker Mayfield. So I think those are the two safest bets that, you know, they're not going to blow the doors off, but they're going to give you a nice safe floor.
Yeah, I think it depends, you know, how much do you want to spend? I mean, Minshew probably shouldn't cost you too much. I mean, maybe a second plus now that, you know, people know that you need a quarterback for the rest of the season.
Oh, yeah, they're going to get you.
You're going to pay the tax. Yeah.
You know, you're going to have to pay at least a tax on that. And I don't want to pay for, you know, a Russ, even a Howell at this point. Like, people like Howell.
Yeah.
You know, like you said, we don't know what's going to happen. Wise. But yeah, I think I'm with you guys too. Minshew and Baker are probably two of the guys that I'd be looking at to replace.
Safest and cheapest.
Yep. So they're both probably cost you maybe a second plus, I think, at this point. Or even a Dobbs, like, do we know, like, for sure if it's going to be Jaren Hall or Dobbs? Like, what if Jaren Hall plays good this game? Do we continue on with him? I mean, or maybe you do you go the cheap route and just buy Heinicke and Ridder for, like, two-thirds or safe and just, all right, I got both of them?
No, because as Bagala said, you don't know which way that situation's going. At least if I get Minshew or Sam Howell or even who's the other guy you brought up?
But that's what I'm saying. What if you can't get those guys? What if the tax is too much on those guys? Would you spend 1 second and get Heinicke and Ridder and have both of them, you know, and then you have both of them?
If I'm going to do that, if I have to, if you're telling me I have to, yeah.
If that was an option. Because the guy that has Baker is like, you know what, I'm not giving up Baker unless you give me Ayuk.
Well,
I think he's got a chance, like you said, maybe he gets a deal with the Bucks or something like that.
Yeah, I think he's there for the rest of the year. But I don't want Heinicke and or Ridder. Like if that's my last option, I'll fucking the guy that got Daniel Jones or Zach Wilson.
Let's just play. Let's just say, because they're not all going to be available, right, in every league. Let's just say the Minshew owner, that's on a contending team, so you can't get Minshew. Baker's on a contending team. Geno's on a contending team. We can't get those guys. So we've Dobbs, Jimmy, Howell, Mac Zach Jones. Wilson, Daniel Jones, maybe Mac Jones. I mean, let's just say that, you know, those guys that we said aren't available, you can't get those guys. Who is another guy maybe that you'd like to go after?
Jimmy G and Mac Jones, I feel like they're kind of limited, right? And they've been talking about benching Jimmy G right now. He was like, that performance last night was so bad. You know, it was so bad.
Trash.
Yeah, it was so bad, right? And so they even talking about benching them. And I feel like they're limited. If I'm going to pay for something like that, I'd rather pay for some upside, right? So, and I know he's been horrible, and I know he's been hurt, but guess what? He can run his ass off. I'll go get Danny Dimes. At least he gives me the upside of running, and he's going to be dirt cheap right now, right? So give me the guy with the rushing upside that if he somehow gets his shit together, and maybe he can give you some good games, right? Because we've seen Daniel Jones put up 30-point games. Right, 38-point games, 40-point games, because he can run with his legs, and I would rather do that than go for a Mac Jones with a, you know, or with Mac Jones with no weapons, and Jimmy G, who you don't know if he's going to start the next week because he might throw it into the parking lot while Davante Adams is running a 3-yard slant. So I'd rather, you know, or give me Zach. At least I know Zach is going to be there.